tell you, this whole chamber, at times there would be, how many men in here, Dale, at one time?
Seven or eight.
Now I'm looking straight up now. Uh-oh, I hear...
Bucket coming up!
Oh, bucket. Yeah, now this is what they do. They haul the buckets up, and then... Dale puts them on, and Ed up there is hoisting it up through the hole, and Simon's grabbing it and handing it to Nathan, and Nathan's giving it to Mark, who's hauling it off to the dump.
Boom.
Dale, you got any buckets empty out there?
Yep.
One down below?
It is straight down, Ron says, about 40 foot down here. See, we're just standing on, we're in a hole. We're standing on boards that have been laid across to the ledges.
Coming down?
All right.
That's how the buckets come down. I missed that, but they just toss them down the hole.
First time in 10 months.
Well done.
That's a big one.
Should have knocked that one over.
We're going to follow Mark over to the bus station. See, what they have to do is every time they get buckets of dirt or rock out of there, they have to walk along this path. Now we're heading towards the bus station, where this morning they got tear gassed twice. And Ron was over here dumping rock at the time and got it full force. This is where they dump. You can see it's quite full. We're standing now at the edge of the garden tomb area where the bus station is, looking outwards in the direction of the excavation. Now, we're walking around, we're going to go up and look at the bus station where all the tear gas came from this morning. There it is. I'll get over here in a better position. By far, it is straight down. Where the wall is, down to where the excavation is, which is right there. We're looking right into the area that it is, right there. It's where Christ was actually crucified. And then right around the corner is his tomb.
Jerusalem is situated on two mountains, Mount Zion on the west and Mount Moriah on the east. Moriah extends from the Temple Mount on the south end and continues beyond the city wall to the north. In ancient times, a dry moat was cut through this mountain to prevent invading armies from easily entering the city from the north. The northern part of the mountain, located outside of the city, was then used at some point in time as a quarry, and where the mountain was cut away is very visible. Along the escarpment or cliff face, which was formed when it was quarried, is located the tomb. Also along this escarpment is the well-known skull face. And between the skull face and the tomb is the site Ron Wyatt pointed to in 1978 when he said, "That's Jeremiah's grotto, and the Ark of the Covenant is in there." North of the city wall of Jerusalem sits a beautiful garden. Within this garden is the tomb known as the Garden Tomb, chiseled into the rock of the northern part of Mount Moriah.
Okay, now we're going to go in. Here we can see inside of the tomb. Very old cross. This one is just as it was originally carved out. This is a very small area. I don't know if someone was to be buried there or not. But here, we can see, right back here, it was dug out more, presumably because Christ was taller to accommodate him. Was out this door that Christ walked. Walked on this floor.
Discovered when I started excavating down that cliff wall, first of all, I discovered the cutouts in the wall of the cliff where they had posted the signs.
We painted or drew Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews, in the Roman and the Greek and the Hebrew languages, and we put them there, and we set this up to resemble what happened to Christ on the cross. Okay, now the cross hole is actually right straight down below where we set this thing up. And of course this is the chamber that you've been looking around through with us as we worked.
Now this whole fill here needs to be taken out. Now here we have niches. These are where the titles of the criminals that were crucified were placed, the name and what they were accused of. This is one right here. And then there's one right up there. And then, of course, there's one right under that rubble right there that we have filmed before. All of that needs to come out, and right back directly behind and under all of that rubble is a cross hole right directly below the center line of these niches. And then out from that is a first century Christian church and the massive 13-foot, 2-inch stone that sealed the sepulcher that Christ was buried in is affixed into the wall of that first century church that's buried on this site. And this, then, is the Calvary Scarp, or escarpment, the place outside the city on the north side where most of the traffic passed through that criminals were executed.